Did the Australian government want to be blackmailed by UNESCO over the Great Barrier Reef? Duplicity, hypocrisy, grubby politics, anti-science, you name it, this story's got it. Now, last year, UNESCO threatened Australia that it was going to declare the Great Barrier Reef as endangered because of climate change and pollution from farms. It was like blackmail. If you don't do what UNESCO demands, then the reef's reputation is going to be officially smeared. Now, I've been arguing on many videos that the reef is not particularly threatened by climate change. After all, a gently warming climate will make the reef grow faster because corals like it hot, in fact. But let's for now go along with this. And after all, the science institutions have been saying that the reef will lose 99% of its coral with a 1.5 to 2 degree temperature rise. And we've already, according to them, seen a 1 degree temperature rise. So we're more than halfway to 99% loss of corals. Now, we'll also try to forget that the reef has now got more coral than since records began. And we'll go along with the government and the 99% loss of coral. Then you have to agree that the reef is endangered. That's about as endangered as you can get. How on earth can the government argue any other way if they believe all this catastrophism? And nothing Australia can do will impact the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere. China, India, and the rest of the world are going to decide that. So why is the government fighting against this endangered listing? Now, you might think the government has finally got sensible and realises it will be bad for Australia's reputation and very bad for the tourist industry. And there is a little bit of that, to be fair. But it's actually very useful for an extreme left-wing government to have this external sword of Damocles hanging over the reef, because it means the government can pass the buck and say, we've got to do all these things, otherwise UNESCO will declare it as endangered. We don't have any choice. But let's look at some of the things that the government has promised to do to stop the UNESCO listing. They've agreed to stop the gillnet fishing of barramundi on the east coast. Now, barramundi is an iconic fish in northern Australia, and it's fished very sustainably. But the barra are caught in the creeks and rivers, tens, if not far more than that, kilometres away from the Great Barrier Reef, which is way offshore. Now, they've never explained how stopping fishing on the coast is saving the reef, which is offshore. People certainly talk about, well, the gillnets occasionally catch a very odd turtle, but they haven't explained how that's going to be affecting the reef. And don't forget that there's plenty of hunting of turtles by the indigenous people, especially in the Torres Strait near on the reefs there, and I don't think that's killing the reef either. But it actually gets worse, because Ms. Plibersek from the federal government environment ministry is now restricting fishing in the southern Gulf of Carpentaria to save the reef. This was a promise to UNESCO. Now, that area of the Gulf is 700 to 800 kilometres away from the reef on the wrong side of Cape York Peninsula. How can catching a barra or a fish on Mornington Island affect the reef? Now, just to give you a feeling of how incredibly far that is from the reef, that's more than the distance from Melbourne to Sydney or San Francisco to Los Angeles. It's halfway across Europe, for goodness sake. And no reason given. It was just done to appease UNESCO. Was this really demanded by UNESCO, or was it being used as a convenient tool by our government to further enforce extreme green environmental policies? Now, make no mistake about it, this government and many others are very anti-fishing. Australia now imports about 2/3 of our seafood, despite owning one of the biggest areas of sea of any country and having a very small population. So what you see here is the government taking advantage of the threat by UNESCO enlisting to do something that they actually want to do already, which is further strangle the fishing industry to appease the green fringe in the inner city. They want to be blackmailed. And the last thing they need is for UNESCO to actually declare the reef as endangered, because then the blackmail will stop, you see, and they lose this beautiful excuse to do the next crazy thing, and who knows what that will be, but very likely further restrictions on fertiliser use on farms and further and reducing the number of cattle on the cattle stations. Now, this blackmail tango will go on for years. The government saying the reef is endangered to farmers, but not endangered to the UNESCO. They're saying, please keep blackmailing us so we can finish off the fishing industry and start on the farmers, because we're in the inner city and we don't have a brain. We don't think we need to eat. But the real moral of the story is that the government is actually arguing that the Great Barrier Reef is not endangered, going against their own institutions and its own rhetoric, but quite correct, actually. This is beautiful hypocrisy, duplicity, deceitful politics, and completely free of proper science.